Hello scrubbers, in this video I will show you how to use silver testing solution to identify silver in different types of objects. What is the silver testing solution? Silver testing solution can be bought like this commercial product. This paper tube contains solution of potassium dichromate, nitric acid, and distilled water. When a drop of this solution is put on a silver object, nitric acid attacks the silver object. So silver goes into solution. It reacts with potassium dichromate, and you see a very distinguishable and specific red color that indicates presence of silver. So in our case, I will do a couple of experiments. First, I will check how this silver testing solution works on silver objects with different percentage of silver, from 100% to 50%. Then I will show you how to use it for silver plated objects. And at the end, I'll show you how to use it on electronic scrap. It's always kept in these dark bottles because it's light sensitive. If you want this solution to be used for a very long time, you have to keep it in a dark place and not expose it to extreme overheating or not to freeze it. So take care of your testing solution and it will serve for a very, very long time to you. Let's start. Here on the top row, I put coins and different silver objects that contain different amount of silver. Let's put a drop from the testing solution to each of them. So this is pure silver. This is 92% silver. This is 83% silver. This is 60% silver. This is 58% silver. And this is 50% silver. After that, I will scratch these objects with paper like this and show you each of them what kind of coloration gives. So with the coins, it's not so easy. I will just take a stamp like this. It's here, it's here, and it's here. Let me put it on top so we can see the results. Okay. If you take 100%, 92%, 82% even, or 62%, you can clearly see nice red color that is silver dichromate. This is the product of the reaction of silver with dichromate. Of course, the lower the amount of silver you have, less coloration you see. So you can compare easily 100% with 62%, with 58%, with 50%. It's significantly less, but it's clear that silver is present here. In all these cases, you see silver presence. This is the red color. You have to very carefully use this method because in many cases, people just silver plate objects, not made them of silver. Here I took a very good example. This is a spoon, and this spoon has a hallmark. This hallmark says 90, which means silver plating. It's a German one. Let's put one drop of this solution on top of this object, like this. We wait a couple of seconds. And let's see if we have silver here. After waiting a little, so it clears the potassium dichromate, what is left here is clear sign of silver. And it's very intensive silver. You can compare it to the high percentage silver objects. Which means that if you don't have this hallmark, or if you don't know what it means, you can easily be fooled that this is made of silver, but actually this is just silver plating. Here I took another spoon. that was broken, just to show you how it's easy to recognize if it's silver plated or silver. I'll put a drop here. And if you have just this object and you put one drop, you may decide that this is silver object, because you see this specific red color, and this red color resembles high percentage of silver samples. But that's not the case. Let me show you this part here. I decided to remove the surface layer. You can scratch, or you can grind the surface layer and expose the metal in depth, not just the surface. So here you put one drop, and we believe we removed the surface layer of silver. Let's remove it like this. And you see significant difference. This is the same spoon, but here it looks like you have a lot of silver, and here there is no sign of silver. That's why if you have any concerns, you should always scratch and go deep into the object to find the base metal and to test the base metal, because that's how you will not be fooled by the sellers. And this one is even more interesting because it's gold plated here. And many times when object is gold plated, you just put a drop like this of your testing solution. And gold is protecting the layer under. So you can't see if there is any silver or not. So it's essential to remove the surface layers, or to cut the object, or to go in depth to test for silver. So here you see only one red line. This means a small defect on the surface where the acid managed to dissolve a little silver and to give you this red line. But here there is no sign. So this spoon is made of base metal. It's silver plated, and on top of the silver plating, you have some gold plating in this area. That's how you can give fair price to people and they don't fool you. It's even more difficult when you do such experiments with rings and jewelries. First of all, it's very difficult to test them because they are round and you can't put a clear good drop of the testing solution on top of them. Second, many times they have a very thick gold layer on top, and you don't know if this is gold or this is a silver object that is gold plated. For example, this ring has very good gold plating. It's very difficult to test for silver. You have to cut it or to scratch it or to make really deep scratch to reach the silver on it. This ring is a little easier to test. Let's try. I will, because I see some areas where the gold plating was weird, probably it was used for a very long time. Let's put a drop here. And you see the drop is not sitting there. The drop is trying to find its way. But let me show you the result. So it's clear silver sign. You have the coloration that gives you information that this is silver. And these two rings have hallmarks, by the way. They say silver, sterling silver, 925 parts from 1,000 silver. I can show you also other types of silver objects. These ones have hallmarks. It's clear that this is silver spoon, but here you can also see they are gold plated. So if you want to test such, you have to remove the gold plating or to find a defect into the gold plating and test for silver there. Let's check this one. You see, there are some small scratches on the surface. So I hope nitric acid will manage to dissolve a little from the silver and tell me if this is silver that is gold-plated. Here you see this specific red color appears, which means that this spoon is made of silver and it was gold-plated on top. Okay, let's go to electronic scrap at the end. Here is something common. This is from relay or industrial switch. You have these silver contacts. So it's very easy to test them. You just put a drop on top. And because usually they have 80% silver, or some of them close to 100, or even 50, but in all cases, you see very, very, very distinguishable red color. So this tells you that you have high percentage of silver in this contact. But I also see that this object looks silver plated. Let me put a drop on top of this base metal, and I'll just take another sample. So this was the silver contact, and this is the base metal that is silver plated. You see, this is more intensive color, but this color also shows that you have silver plating on top of this contact. Let me put it here aside so you can see all these testings and we can compare. And let's go to another electronic scrap. In many cases, you have pins, and you are wondering, are these pins covered with silver? So you put a small drop on top of the pins, and you get a nice result. You see the red color. These pins are silver plated. So that's how you can identify silver plated pins and sell them or process them for silver instead of just throwing them as base metal. What is the most difficult to test? Most difficult is this type of silver plating because it's very thin. You have a lot of base metal here and you have a very thin silver layer on top. Let me put a couple of drops and I'll try to put them to cover as much as possible of these silver contacts. Let's wait a little bit more because I want as much as possible silver to react. Let's see now the result. We covered three contacts with silver, and as you can see on the places where the three contacts were, we have some clear marks that are showing red color. So this is silver plated, but silver is very, very small amount here. So I'll put it here just to compare it with the others. As you can see from all these tests, it's clear that when you have 50 to 100% silver in the objects, you can catch it with this method. In some cases, not so easy. You see the lower percentage, not so clear red color. The lower goes the percentage of silver, the less silver dichromate is formed, and this coloration is not so visible. About silver-plated objects, if you want to be sure that object is not silver-plated, you have to scratch it or cut it and check what is inside, if you have any doubts. And electronic scrap, it's a perfect method to identify silver plating or silver contacts. I use it every day. Finally, I would like to say that this solution contains nitric acid. It's a commercial product, so it's all written here. But you have to be very, very careful when you use it. Read carefully the instructions for use, and in case this goes into your eyes clog on your skin, you have to immediately wash your eyes or hands with a lot of water. And if irritation continues and you have some medical condition, please consult a physician. That's how I test silver objects, and trust me, it saved me a lot of money over the years. Identifying some fake silver and some silver plating sold for solid one. Thanks for watching. Keep scrapping and good luck with silver. Price is rocketing these days.